Oh, I wish it'd be alive. Not lifting its head, that's not a good sign. We're disappointed to see so many wash ashore in association with this cold snap and so many that were found dead, but on the other hand, it indicates that the population's increasing, so that's a positive sign for us. The green sea turtle was once actually so abundant in Texas that it was commercially exploited. And between the overexploitation and severe freezes in the late 1800s, the population plummeted.
There we go. Yeah, there he is.
And after years and years of conservation efforts, now the green turtle population is increasing in Texas. There's a statewide network that's working very hard on going out and searching for the stranded turtles, responding to reports of them, bringing them into rehabilitation, those that are alive, to receive care.
It's all right?
Yep.
Okay, because I've not been able to open his mouth. Poor thing.
Hi, buddy.
Well, I thought you were gonna.
During recovery efforts, examples of that included our law enforcement folks actually collecting the turtles themselves, and when they're not able to reach the rehabbers, take them to their house, putting them in the bathtubs, letting them acclimate, and getting their core temperature back up until they're transported to the rehab center.
Primarily when these guys come in and they're cold stunned, we're looking to check their blood sugar as well as their electrolytes. Very commonly when they're cold stunned, their blood sugar drops really low, and that's something that we can correct and improve our survival rate. So luckily this guy's a little feistier than some of them are. Each one of these goes into a medical record. All 70 some odd animals have their own medical record that we're able to keep track of what we need to do for them treatment wise. And as they progress and as they start to get better, they start to move out of the intensive care type of therapy into a more of a maintenance therapy and care before they get released back out into the wild.